Welcome back to segment two of our highlight coverage of the Key West Offshore Poker Run 2016. This is Stu Jones. This event is presented by Mercury Racing with grand prize sponsorship from offleaseonly.com. We're catching up once again with our Wednesday departure group, leaving from Miami, heading down through Biscayne Bay, as we join Dustin Zumo from Oklahoma. His first time in his very own boat on the run. It's a 2004 38 Top Gun. He's done the Key West event several times in the past with member Mike Pierce. Says that he really had a great time. It was a well-organized and a well-planned event. I love the look and really love the sound of this 2004 Top Gun. It's got a pair of Mercury Racing 525s with that through-hole exhaust. Sounds like a mean machine. It looks like they're having a great ride today. Ready, steady, go. Now let's say hi to David and Casey Womack all the way from Texas with this 38-foot Fountain powered by Mercury Racing 525s, Team Intimidator. Cool story about this couple. They joined us on the Bahamas run this past summer. They had a drive failure, idled all the way back in the Gulf Stream to Fort Lauderdale, repaired the boat, turned around, and headed all the way back to meet us in Chubb Key 2 days later. Now we're catching up with Roger and Pam Anderson, also from Texas. Not their first rodeo. They've been on the Key West Poker Run several times, but not in their own boat. They always join their son. But now they've got a great program. They bought this brand new 2017 Nortec with triple 350 Mercury Verados to keep this boat in Florida while they keep their 42-foot Fountain Lightning in Texas for doing summer poker runs. I'd say that's a pretty good combination and a great way to enjoy the Florida boating lifestyle. Ready. Now let's welcome Frank Giannucci Jr. all the way from New Jersey with this 353 Formula Fast Tech. Got some big power in this thing. It says 650 horsepower aside, so I assume those are 5 1/4 that are beefed up. But first time here on the Key West Poker Run. Welcome to the Jersey boys to join us. Looks like they're having a great ride here as they enjoy the calm waters of Biscayne Bay. Another 42 Fountain here coming down through the bay waters. This is Jim Stockton, also from Texas. Not his first rodeo. He's done another poker run with the club. We saw him up at the Emerald Coast Poker Run this past summer. Love the graphics on this boat. Jim says it was painted by the Martin Brothers in Texas. And a very special welcome to David and Marianne Kramer, another New Jersey team. And a very, very thoughtful and interesting bio that was presented to us. I got to tell you, David, very impressed with all of the great comments you gave us. Sorry about the slow fuel pumps at Holover Marine Center. We're going to work on getting that fixed because that got you behind and you missed your bonus card at Grove Harbor. Thanks for the comments, and we'll make sure that doesn't happen again. David, after all these years of planning Key West, I'm so glad you guys finally made it. Now let's welcome Andy and Eileen Templeman from Indiana, a long way from home, in this brand new 39 Nortec center console called Team Premier Obsession. Triple Mercury 350 Verados. Notice that the engine cowlings painted silver to match the silver paint on the boat. Just very simple and at the same time very stylish. Altogether, over 25 Nortecs registered for this run. Now let's say hi to Chris Ribeiro from Texas. Been on a number of poker runs with the club. Seems to be enjoying this center console, which is called Team Low Maintenance. I'm not sure if he's referring to his girlfriend, Ray, or the Donzi center console. Either way, it's a good thing. It's nice to see David Beach coming back. He's a veteran of this event, all the way from New Jersey, in this 37 Outer Limits Team Rockin' Rye 3. As always, some of the front runners are already here at Gilbert's in Key Largo, and a few that got a head start, but at this point, we're going to let everybody get settled in at Gilbert's, have a lunch stop, and wow, what a gorgeous day it is, as you see here in Jewfish Creek. Flying the drone here underneath the Jewfish Creek Bridge, but of course the helicopter is going to remain out because remember, there's still dozens of boats making their way across the bay waters, so we want to make best use of the time. Here's Adam Carpenter and Amy Gold in their 34-foot Sensation. It's all black and hard to keep clean, he says. Adam said in his video bio that the reason he keeps coming back is because all the great people and the cool location heading to Key West. Another big center console, a 42-foot Huntress. This one belongs to Derek Wacom from Oklahoma. Plan B is the appropriate name for this boat because Plan B allows Derek and his crew to jump from one boat to another. Of course, he's running his 52-foot MTI, but he needs to have this big platform to carry all his other guests and family, and that's worked out great on these big poker runs. Now we're joining Carl Waite from the Daytona Beach area in this big 48 Fountain Express Team Mine. That's right, M-I-N-E. So obviously the bank doesn't own it. Cool story, because we met him in the Bay Area here. He had the hatches open, was working on the boat. Turns out he blew a hydraulic line, but he's obviously pretty handy with the tools because he was able to get the boat fixed and up and running. And this was kind of a reward for him because I actually held the helicopter back. We were riding alongside in the Ocean Hawk. And so the helicopter got a lot of time with him, and it turned out to be a great photo shoot. Look at the rooster tail shooting out the back of this 48-foot Express. And here's how it looked from our side as we rode on the boat's direct 33-foot Ocean Hawk pace boat. Now let's welcome Jason Hearn and his gal Jody all the way from West Virginia. And look at them. They are pumped up for this ride. You can tell they've been planning for quite a while. They're joined by their friends Mike and Lori Wendo, who just got married previous Saturday, so this was their honeymoon vacation. Awesome trip. Another center console, a 38 statement. Say hi to Andrew and Danielle Rocco from New Hampshire. We saw a lot of them in the last segment of this show. Now let's welcome Rick Denev all the way from Iowa in this 32-foot Sensation CCX. He's running with Jared Morris and the factory team from Sensation, and they were sponsors of this event, so we got a chance to catch up with one of the owners, Joe Schaldenbrand, at the Fort Lauderdale Boat Show. Well, Joe, in the boat business, they say that if you've got a model that's really successful, then you need to start basing your next model on that model. But I think that the 34 CCX has always been a home run, as we all know. So you can go bigger or you can go smaller, but in today's market, I think most people are looking to get into a boat and not get killed, you know, and have a second mortgage on their house. So you came up with this 32 probably for that reason. And you get the same styling, right, the same performance, a nice cabin, two engines instead of three. So not a bad package. How did this boat come to be?
Well, we designed this boat because of the success of the 34 CCX. And we have a lot of customers who purchased our sport boats who can evolve into this. They wanted something. It's a foot narrower, has a lot of the same styling, a lot of the same amenities. That boat was a success, so we just scaled it down, came out with this. This has the twin 350s on it. The hull, we started with Trace Martin Design. We brought Trace in early and helped design the hydrodynamics of the boat, designed the hull, and it is an incredible running product. The first time we took it out, we had a home run right off the bat. We have sold several of them, and it's working well.
Off of the first one. And to round out the Sensation sponsor segment is Jared Morris, one of the co-owners of the company in this 34 CCX. It's a hot rod powered by triple Mercury Racing 400Rs. Arriving again now in Jewfish Creek, as most of the pack is now gathered up for the lunch stop at Gilbert's. Looks like these Sensations are just pulling off the throttle for safety. And let's say hi to our final team before we break for lunch. This is Steve and Marina Johnson from Florida, a 382 Formula. A lot of formulas on this run today. I got to say, I don't believe we've seen so many in recent years, but what an awesome shot as the drone just catches them at the perfect moment and gets this money shot as they pull the throttles back and arrive here at the lunch stop. What an amazing day. Now we're going to feature some of these drone highlights, which I think are fantastic video clips. There's the Sea Ray Amphibious just going up to the beach right now. But just look how beautiful the weather has been, how light the winds are. The bay waters here are so calm. I can see in the background there's still a few boats trickling in here to Jewfish Creek. I know that we had close to 50 altogether registered for the Wednesday event. And so the timing of this shot is probably earlier when some of the front runners were just arriving. But there's that brand new 34 MTI. Say thanks to our friends from Florida Fish and Wildlife, and on board with them are the Miami-Dade Fire Rescue Safety Divers and Rescue Paramedics, who are part of the Florida Powerboat Club Safety Management Program. And of course, it goes without saying, a big shout out to the staff at Gilbert's, because They pretty much give us all of the docks that we need to stage these lunch stopovers. And it's a difficult task because when you have 50 or 60 boats all taking the spaces along here, about 500 feet of bulkhead, and of course we need virtually every foot of linear dock space that we could possibly get in order to dock this humongous fleet. There's a nice shot of Ray Grimaud and Team Big Shot, one of the new 42 Mystics that we're starting to see a lot more of on these poker runs. Of course, getting fuel is one thing you can do here at Gilbert's, but we don't always recommend it. We're only about 50 miles into the run, and with another 50 miles, we're going to reach Marathon, and the Ferro Blanco's got plenty of fuel. So I think the important thing to do is get inside, get some food, and have some fun. It's a lot of work managing the logistics of these events, especially when we've got to go 160 miles. So we keep people informed through texting and announcements here from the stage. Most importantly, we'd like people to not take off from Gilbert's until the helicopter is out flying and ready to shoot the group heading through the Florida Keys. In a matter of moments, everybody was back on the boats and making their way out to Blackwater Sound for the next leg of the run, which will take them about 60 miles from Key Largo down to Marathon for a fuel stop. For the next 10 or 15 miles of the ride, we'll be going through mangrove waterways, which is very critical navigation. Now the helicopter's up and flying, the drone is out, so it's a good chance to say hi to everybody. Hey, Tristan. Hey, Tyson. And get a close look at all the crews before we head out for the next leg of the run. Say hi to Jim Lee and his girls on Team Double Take, 46-foot skater. And Jim always has a spirited crew on board. Keep me begging, keep me hoping that the night don't stop. We saw this boat just a little earlier, but here's a closer shot of Jared and Heather Morris from Iowa on their 34 Sensation CCX with triple Mercury Racing 400Rs. Now we're catching up with John Evans, who actually lives in Key West, a good friend of ours from Team Hydro Thunder, 38-foot cigarette Top Gun. He just picked up this boat a couple of weeks before the poker run, was so anxious to go on the Key West poker run, and kept calling me and telling me that he was getting himself a boat, and here he is. So congratulations, John. You did it. You got yourself a beautiful ride, and it looks like you got a fun crew on board today. Here's a good shot that indicates how our safety management crew is on station. This is a Florida Fish and Wildlife boat with two rescue paramedics on board as everyone slows down to pass safely through the mangrove waterways. Here's another look at this Freedom 28 skater, Tristan and Tyson Garvin. Hey, what's the deal, Tristan? 1 minute ago you had your bikini on and now you got like your parka on. It's not that cold out, is it? And here's another shot of Jim Lee on Team Double Take. Looks like the girls bundled up for the next leg of the ride. We can all agree that this is one of the most scenic and exciting parts of the ride down through the Florida Keys, but at the same time, it's indeed one of the most critical because you can see how narrow the waterways are, and quite often, you'll see Ma and Pa and the kids out fishing off to the side in these mangrove canals because this is where a lot of the fish are. So this is where it's important for everybody to just chill out and just manage the speeds and get into single file. I mean, to me, this is the money shot. Look how everybody's just taking their time, cruising at a very comfortable speed and really enjoying the scenery. So if you've got cameras or iPhones, get them out and take some pictures and check out some of the wildlife when you're going by, because this is what the Florida Keys are all about, and this is what we want you guys to enjoy as one of the highlights of the Key West Poker Run. And I will say this, you know, I complain a lot and I scold a lot, and you see me pretty, you know, upset sometimes when I see some of these things that I think are unsafe. But this particular day, I want to say everybody was amazingly safe. They followed the guidelines that we outlined to everyone. You guys are really getting good at this, and I want to commend all of you. Don't you tell me no truth, I want honey and lies. Oh, well.
Just had a great lunch at Gilbert's in Key Largo, and we jumped in the boat because we knew that everyone was getting ready to leave and head towards Marathon, so we didn't want to miss the opportunity for some great shots. So we positioned the Ocean Hawk back there in the mangroves, and we let everybody come up alongside, and we flew the drone for a little bit and got some good video and some good pictures. Looks like most of the pack has already gone through, so they're going to be have an ETA in Marathon about 2 p.m. We're going to follow up the rear, try to get there and catch up with them, see how everything's going. So far, though, a great day here as we head down for the Florida Keys on the 24th annual Key West Pokemon.
Now we're going to catch up to everybody as they get up to speed, heading through these bay waters, and chance to open up the throttles a bit. Bo and Tiffany Renfro from Georgia, 368 skater powered by Mercury Racing 700s. Team is called Dirty Money. They've got another boat back at home, a 48-foot Fountain Express, which they use to cruise around on Lake Lanier. Don't you tell me no truth, I want all of your lies. Getting a close shot again of Steve and Marina Johnson in their 38-foot Formula. It seems like you guys always get a great video going through the mangroves when you're cruising about 35 miles per hour. So we know this boat goes faster, but look at these cool shots. So you guys really got lucky with the camera work. You know, earlier with the drone and this time with the helicopter, but some nice shots of this 38 Formula. Well, speaking of money shots, here's a guy who's getting the bird's eye view, Luis Otero from Miami. In his Sea Ray amphibious aircraft, he's got GoPros mounted to all the wings, and he's given us some great shots of today's event. Now we're joining once again Lauren Peters, 40-foot MTI called Team Change Order, all the way from Missouri. Love the paintwork, the blues and the blacks and the whites on this 40 MTI. We saw a lot of Lauren in the last episode, segment one of our Key West coverage, and it looks like he's getting a lot more love from the helicopter again. And why not? You know, what a good-looking boat. Catching up one more time now with Jim Stockton and his son Adam from Texas in this 42 Fountain 2006 model with supercharged Mercury Racing 525s and some wild graphics. Want to thank Jim for his bio. He told us that the event was well organized with multiple events to attend while in Key West. He'd never had the boat out in open water before, so Key West was on his bucket list, and he trailered the boat 1,500 miles to be here. Back with Chris Ribeiro here in this 38 Donzi, a triple Mercury Verados, brought the boat all the way to the Bahamas with us earlier this year. And I do want to comment, though, I know why he called the boat low maintenance. His other boat is a 45 Cigarette Maximus with Mercury Racing 1075. So compare that to this new boat. I would say that the team low maintenance is a great name for this Donzi. And here's Chris passing Chris. That's right, Christian McCauley along with Andrea on board. They're from New Hampshire. This 46-foot Outer Limits called Team All Set. It's got some Big Chief engines. It's the only Outer Limits 46 cat that looks anything like this with beautiful orange paint job. Well, I love the graphics. I love the way the boat looks, and look at how it runs. Like a champ. Making our way through these bay waters, we saw David Womack on the left earlier. There's Don Lightfoot on the right at the top of your screen. That's a 52-foot Nortec Roadster powered by Mercury Racing 1350s. Here's another awesome Outer Limits SV52 owned by Joel Bejean from Quebec, Canada. This one's powered by Mercury Racing 1350s, and it's one of about 19 Outer Limits registered for the event. Nice to see Joel back on the Poker Run circuit after his terrible accident 2 years ago at the Lotto Shootout. Yeah. Now let's welcome Jake and Gina Nossaman all the way from Oklahoma. Team Wired Up is a 48-foot MTI powered by Mercury Racing 1350s. And Jake is a very spirited and enthusiastic performance boater. I remember meeting him almost 10 years ago when he came to the Emerald Coast Poker Run in his 29-foot DCB Cat. So he's got a boat twice the size now, so somehow he's doing well and enjoying the sport. I believe now we're making the turn at green marker 61. Yep, there it is. As we basically clear Key Largo area, now we're into Tavernier and making our way closer to Isla Morada as the helicopter once again gets right down close on Steve and Marina Johnson. Something about this boat you guys must have liked because they got a lot of helicopter time in this segment. Ah, now I know why. They want to get a closer look at your ladies. Just a quick shot here of this deep impact. I believe it's a 33, one of the predecessors from the current owners. But hey, it's a deep impact, so we left it in. Twin Yamaha outboards. Love the surf foam green, and it's a perfect boat for cruising around down here in the Florida Keys. And a sharp contrast to that twin-engine center console now is this big monster 40-foot skater. This is Team Savage, Cole and Grant Witcher from California. Big 1350 Sterlings, this 2008 skater. It came here all the way on a trailer from California. They trailered it from Orange County, California. It was their first time here on the Key West Poker Run, and it's the first time that Cole says that he's owned a skater. His favorite thing about powerboating, he says, going fast, the good people, and showing off his boat. Now we're going to closer look here at Team Gold Digger, David Landsman from Maryland. He's actually got two boats registered for the run. His brand new Deep Impact with quad 400Rs is going to run on the Thursday run. So he thought he would just bring the Gold Digger out here and have some fun here on Wednesday. But it looks like he's not having a lot of fun because something's wrong with the boat. He's obviously cruising about 50 miles an hour, which indicates he might have a problem with one of his engines. I'm sure he's headed to the next boat ramp. And it gives this skater, party crasher on the right, a chance to slow down and steal some of David's video time. Catching up to David Beach and his crew once again, all the way from New Jersey in this year 2000, 37 Outer Limits Stiletto model, one of the first models that were ever built by Outer Limits. And got twin 750 Ron Potter motors, so you know that's going to push this boat really fast. They're just chilling out today as they cross over these bay waters, enjoying the ride, and having a fantastic time on the Key West Run. And just a reminder to all of our viewers that are watching this, we use all of the video footage that we get from the helicopter in these videos. So as the chopper goes through the pack, it might pick one boat up and then again later, but we're going to keep putting you guys in the show until the show is over. Two Black Beauties riding side by side. This is Derek Walkup's 52-foot MTI Black Diamond, a showstopper everywhere it goes. And riding alongside the new 34-foot MTI Cat, powered by a pair of Merc 400Rs. So together, these two will ride around, and that gives Derek another four or five seats to have some of his guests join them for the poker run. Another bit of trivia that I learned about that 34 Cat is actually has extra fuel cells carrying C16 race fuel so that they can fuel the big boat, the 52, because it's got Mercury Racing dual fuel 1550. So if they want to pump up the power, they'll dump in some race fuel. They can come up alongside, put some race fuel in, and go out and push the throttles and have some fun. But they're not pushing the throttles very hard right now because they got caught in this little mangrove waterway and had to pull back on the sticks and keep the speed contained as they got through this critical area. One more time now with Roger and Pam Anderson from Texas in their brand new Nortec 39 center console powered by triple Mercury 350s. Easy Money 2. Out of 25 Nortecs registered for the Key West Run, 7 of them were 39 center consoles. Once again now with Frank Giannucci Jr., one of our Jersey boys, 35 Formula 353 team underdog. And I believe it's his first Key West Poker Run. And once again, like I said earlier, I've never seen this many Formulas on this run. It's amazing. And once again, another 39-foot Nortec center console. We saw the Templemans just a few minutes back, Andy and Eileen, all the way from Indiana in Premier Obsession. And again, I can't stress enough just how much I love the silver graphics on this boat. It's just such a simple design, but look at how the water reflects back off the silver paint. Let's say hi once again to Ray and Christine Grimaud from New York, who are enjoying this brand new 42 Mystic powered by triple 350 Verados. Let's find out more about this stylish center console from Scott Shogren, who's heading up the sales. We met him here at the Fort Lauderdale Boat Show just before the poker run.
Made our way down the performance dock here to find that Scott Shogren has been very busy today showing this beautiful 42 Mystic. And I was surprised that after 2 years, Scott, you tell me you've built how many?
This is number 17.
Amazing.
Yeah, it's been a good run for the last 2 years. We introduced it as a prototype in February of 14, started shipping in the summer of 14, and here we are in 16, delivered a 17th one and sold out through number 27.
And I noticed that, I don't think I've seen two that were identical. You're coming out with beautiful fit and finish, changing up the colors, but very traditional, solid colors. No crazy paint jobs, but really fine, nice metallics, which I love. And I think that's what people are liking about this boat.
Yeah, we let our customers go to the car websites to pick colors.
Okay.
And we're really going after a Range Rover theme, not necessarily a performance theme. However, we do have some coming up. In fact, we have one coming for Miami that is going to be over-the-top performance-looking Jaguar orange in color.
Nice.
And loaded with options we've never done before.
And I see you've been going with the trips. I don't know if you've done any quad setups already, have you, or mostly trips?
We're about 50-50, and honestly, I like the triple setup better because in rough water, you don't get the barking of the outside motors.
Right.
As big as this boat is, we still are affected by that, just like our competitors are. But with triple 350s or triple 400s, with 12 people and fuel, you're still over 70 miles an hour with right. either engine package.
I had the pleasure of taking one of your new boats with Ron Zolak down to the Keys earlier this year. Ron, he said, Stu, I think I'm just going to chill out and go for the ride, so I'd like you to drive the boat. So I can say from experience that the boat handles incredibly well, driving it from Pompano Beach all the way to the Florida Keys and back in one weekend. But the one thing that people didn't realize, and I'm sure that they're in shock when they go down and they see that cabin down below.
Yeah, it has a queen-size bed, microwave, TV, fridge, almost 7 feet of headroom. And this is a all-infused foam core carbon-reinforced boat. John Kosker is a naval engineer by trade and a very good one at that. And this boat is it's unbelievable. We're very, very happy with it. We have a 38 coming out in late March, early April, and then we have another boat coming out in the fall. We also are introducing our first recreational fish package boats, and you'll see one of those in Miami as well.
Okay, before I close off, I would be remiss if I did not mention and remind everybody that Mystic is the very same brand that has built the most incredible offshore racing catamarans that we've seen on the race courses, that we've seen on poker runs. So when you see this center console boat, obviously it's a different direction, but it's the same quality, the same styling, the same, I think, naval engineering that was used for those high-speed cats that's gone into this bottom as well.
That's correct. John's taken everything he's learned over the years and put it into this boat. In many aspects, this boat is overbuilt. Everybody saw what it did in the Gulf Stream to Cuba and the Gulf Stream to Bimini, and then also in the Boeing Poker Run when it had no time running with some very well-known brand boats and some really nasty water.
That's it. Well, good to see. It certainly has some pedigree with the brand, and good to see you guys who are all very experienced in this industry out here keeping you guys enjoying the Florida boating lifestyle with boats like this Mystic. Thank you, Scott, and we will see you in Key West.
Can't wait.
Thanks to John Kosker for building a beautiful boat and to Scott Shogren for being a great marketeer. We're going to see a lot more of these Mystic 42s on poker runs with the Florida Powerboat Club. And once again, congratulations to Ray and Christine for their new 42 Mystic. Making his annual pilgrimage to the Florida Keys is Patty Sullivan all the way from Maryland in this 38-foot Donzi team Code Blue. And when I say pilgrimage, well, I pretty much lost track, Patty, of how many times you've done this run, but a perfect platform, this Donzi. We actually have five Donzis on the Key West run. Three of them our triple engine center consoles. And you can see it's a perfect ride for just cruising through the scenic Keys. Well, it's no accident that Spec Ops is right here running alongside with Patty Sullivan, because they're both from Maryland and they're buddies. So they run together on this poker run every year. But David, of course, with his big 48-foot Express, has always got a big crew, 15 to 20 on board. Thanks to David TV from Spec Ops, the owner of Superior Communications, who have been a big sponsor of this event year after year with their amazing prizes, Garmin GPS chart plotters, ICOM handheld radios, and the new Garmin cameras. So awesome prizes, David. Thank you very much for that. I think everyone appreciates getting some nice prizes here on the run. But just look at this team as they just kick back and enjoy this amazing scenic ride through the Florida Keys. And what a great platform to be doing it, this big Fountain Express cruiser. Join me in welcoming back Bob and Carrie Blandford from the Jacksonville area, this time with a CV center console, a 39 powered by quad Mercury Verados. And, you know, Bob, I've lost track of how many boats you've had since you've been around the club for more than a decade, but nice to see you chilling out in this big, huge center console. Look at the bow thruster there. That's kind of cool. What an awesome fishing machine. But today it's not fishing. He's got it on cruise control, headed for Key West. A little bit more time now with Carl Waite. Again, another big 48-foot Fountain Express, this one powered by triple Yanmar 440s. And seems like he's got that repair nailed down, that hydraulic line, and now another 50 miles into the run, it seems like everything's just going fine. One more time for this big cigarette huntress. Skip Braver from Cigarette told me this boat weighs in at about 18.9 from the factory, but the way they have this one rigged, she's at about 22,000 pounds. Captain John T claimed that she'll run 81 miles per hour with these 5 400Rs. Everybody pretty much spread out and just enjoying the ride now here in the Bay Waters as we catch up with Glenn Sellier from Kentucky. 52-foot outer limits. I believe it's got a pair of Mercury Racing 1350s. And we know Glenn has always been an outer limits guy. He started out with a 47 several years back, and he got himself a 50-foot outer limits cat with turbines. And now he's got this 52 with 1350s. A full canopy boat, you can see. Got the lid off and just enjoying the ride. Back with another skater team. Altogether, about 15 skaters registered for the Key West event. This is Matt Garland and Kenny Shop from Kentucky in this 40-foot skater called Downtown One. They've, I think, got a pretty good program going because they're partners on the boat, and I think that makes a lot of sense. I'm not going to give away any secrets, but these guys have some great news coming to them in the very, very near future. And here's the FPC crew in the Ocean Hawk 33, sponsored by Boats Direct USA. I would say we're the official chase boat today, not pace boat, because we're the last boat to arrive, but that's okay. We've done our job, and it's been a good, safe run so far as we get the Wednesday departure group closer and closer to Key West. We are now going to sign off from segment 2 of our 8-part series featuring highlights from the Key West Poker Run 2016. Thanks for watching. And look for part 3 of this series coming very soon. Sunset right here and have another beer in Mexico. Do my best to waste another day.